Could you stand a little taller, just a tad?
Like this?
Yes, yes. The chin a tiny bit lower. Gaze a little more to the right. There! Now, hold the pose. Just a few more minutes. You have such an incredibly singular face. That's a compliment, my lord, out of my mouth. Your particularity gives you character.
You're still here?
We've nearly finished. Have you any more need of me, master?
You haven't forgotten that we're setting sail today, have you?
Of course not.
Your cousin is nowhere to be found. I've searched the palace from cellars to attics. Your uncle is beside himself.
He was of a mind to paint the town last night. Don't worry, I shall track him down. Make care to your own preparations without wrinkling another frown. We'll meet you on the boat.
It's about time your cousin took account of the responsibilities awaiting him. He should go and inform the ambassadors of Telemi and the Bridge Alliance of his departure.
Have no fear, Master. I will go and see them in his name. I beg your pardon, but urgent matters call me away. Might we finish all this later?
Impossible, my lord. You are leaving with the tide, if what I've been told is correct.
I am sorry, sir, truly. I must be going.
My lord, please, I beg you! Her Highness
has personally requested I finish this!
Thank you, cousin, for getting me out of that.
Sire, I'm sorry. I'm afraid that I won't make for good company.
Hey! Green blood!
Kurt.
And so the day has finally come. My royal fledglings are leaving the nest.
Accompanied by their most loyal and tenacious master of arms.
As loyal as your gold.
Oh, enough with the cold mercenary. I know you like us. Still hiding your men in the unsuspecting shadows of the greats of this world, I see.
Hey, our blades are the only thing keeping you dainties alive.
Ha! Kurt! I'm not in need of your protection. I'm no longer a child, you know.
Is that so? Well, let's see. Fight with honor! Me, who thought myself a competent weapons master.
It's becoming a little hard to believe.
Don't add insult to injury. This is humiliating enough. We'll need to get you through the basics, or you risk getting your feathers plucked at the first sign of trouble.
That could definitely come in handy.
In that case, Otto here is going to be your training partner. Go! Fight with honor! It appears we've brushed up on the basics.
It does, and I'd like to be on my way. I've quite the list of things to do before we depart.
Indeed. Remember that you can always train in our barracks on the island if you're feeling rusty.
Are your bags packed for the great departure?
Yes. You know I get by with very little. You're not angry that I'm coming with you, I hope.
On the contrary, I'm thrilled that both you and Sir de Corsillon are joining our party. A few friends at your side in unknown territory is a boon.
Ah, so the old goat is coming too. And there I was thinking I would die of boredom on the trip. By the way, where is our future governor hiding? I was hoping to put his skills to the test as well.
I have no idea. He had plans to celebrate his departure last night, and we haven't seen him since. You know Constantine. I should have gone with him, but my heart wasn't in the mood for celebration. The thought of bidding my mother farewell.
It is never easy to say goodbye. But you should be going to see her now. She must be waiting for you. I'll meet you in front of the palace. Then we'll go and find Constantine together.
Very well. I'll meet you as soon as I've said my goodbyes.
What is this? Have you not been taught to knock? I've asked 1,000 times. Oh, it's you, my dear child.
Mother, I'm sorry. I'm having trouble getting used to your condition.
Come now, let's speak of more pleasant things. I'm so very happy to hear your voice. You remind me so much of your father. I do miss him so. Today is the big day, isn't it? Ready to set sail for that island everyone's talking about.
Yes, but the idea of leaving you behind, alone and ill.
Dying, my child. Alas, there is nothing you can do by staying that would ease my suffering. One thing brings me cheer. They say the island is full of miracles, and we might find a cure.
Even if I were to find it, I would never be able to return in time to...
I know. But it brings me comfort to know my son has left on a mission to heal his people. Come now. It is time for you to take leave. Here, take this with you.
What is it?
A family heirloom. Something that... Take it, and keep it with you. May it bring you good luck. All my blessings go with you, my child. Now, be off.
Sorry, Greenblood.
Look, we can see the masts of the ship that'll be taking us. This is one sacred adventure we're embarking on.
I hope this island will keep its promises.
In order to know that, we'll need to find Constantine first.
You're right. Maybe he's already at the port. He was so eager to leave.
This will be quite the chore to finish before our departure. The commander wants to recover some merchandise from our supplier, but the transporter doesn't want to deliver. I did all I could to persuade. Nothing came of it. All the parliamenting fatigues me. But this is your domain. I wouldn't say no to a little help.
Of course. Where is the supplier?
In the lower boroughs, near the port.
Right then. We'll put it on our list of visits.
Where would you like to begin?
I've been asked to pay visits to the ambassadors of Teleme and the Bridge Alliance before our departure. Their dwellings are not far from here. We could go there first.
Very well. Do you think Constantine will be waiting for us next to the ship?
I don't know, but it's certainly worthy of inspection.
Greetings, Your Excellency.
The merchant is there.
Good day, good sir. How might I be of service?
You can start by explaining to me why you refused to honor the orders agreed upon with the guard.
There's been a misunderstanding, sir. Of course we're ready to honor the orders. In fact, I've already had a word with your master at arms.
They're asking that we pay again, despite having already paid.
It's just that the price has gone up since. I've nothing to do with it.
This is inadmissible. If you agree on a sum, you need to honor that agreement.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm just an agent, and I'm only obeying orders.
Your master has apparently asked you to demand a second payment for this merchandise.
That's right. He told me that their attendant seemed to be hiding something when he passed the order. And so he must have thought the guard would end up paying in the end whatever he asked for.
I'll be damned. And I'm the one they've sent to settle the affair.
Sorry, Captain. It's nothing personal. I'm only following orders.
Following orders? Yeah, we hear you. Makes one wonder which one of the two of us is a coin guard.
Why don't we go and solicit other suppliers, Kurt?
When we've already paid for the merchandise. If these thieves agree to reimburse the original payment, it's what we'd do immediately. And do know, in the future, we won't be shopping with them. Well, I should think not.
This whole story sounds suspicious and stinks of a scandal. You're demanding a second payment, but refuse to reimburse the one that was already made.
I'm not the one demanding nor refusing. It's my master.
This stubborn fool is pushing me to madness. You understand now why I'm asking for your help?
I don't think you understand who you're dealing with. Perhaps I failed to present myself properly. Lord de Sade, nephew of the Prince d'Orsay and legate of the Congregation of Merchants. During our conversation, you explained to me that your master forced you to commit a crime. That's regrettable, especially as you will be considered his accomplice in extortion, theft. You know as well as I that the Congregation does not tolerate such illegal activities.
But I'm only obeying orders.
That is a shame. Well, as orders are the only language you seem to understand, I order you to return the guard the merchandise, without delay. Unless you'd rather your master is hung and that you finish your days in prison.
I beg your pardon, sir, but you are not my master. Moreover, the attendant at the guard was quite specific, saying this affair should be handled with extreme discretion. So I seriously doubt that you'll be wanting to drag us in front of a judge. That would stir up the muck.
Whatever is he talking about, Kurt?
Your guess is as good as mine.
This is preposterous. Your master is a thief. I have no patience for bandits and robbers. Either you give us back what's ours, or we'll take it.
Your idea of diplomacy isn't all that different from my own.
To the devil with you.
Since you leave us no choice.
The merchant's clerk isn't hearing your arguments. The only thing left is a show of strength. Sorry, Greenblood. If I'd have known, I wouldn't have gotten you mixed up in this. He seems to have grown wiser all of a sudden.
Yes, yes! Don't hear me anymore!
Very well.
I'm counting on you to deliver this merchandise as quickly as possible.
Yes, good sir. I'll take care of it immediately.
I still don't see Constantine at your side. I hope he hasn't been the victim of any foul play.
Don't worry. We'll find him in time for departure.
I certainly hope so. Would you be in need of my help in any way?
What will be your official title on Tiafredi? Or are you just here to keep an eye on us?
Come now, don't be ridiculous. I'm coming in the capacity of official advisor. Nothing more. But His Highness has also asked me to report to him on certain strategic observations. I am therefore required to take note of all events, chart the island and its resources, but also obtain as much knowledge as possible concerning the more dangerous creatures of the island. Your help will be extremely valuable to me. I've no longer the legs of an adventurer.
It's always a privilege to help, Master. I need to be leaving. I have quite a few things to do before we raise anchor.
I believe I've seen you at the palace. Are you one of the prince's relatives?
Regret this miraculous opportunity. Your time is precious in these dark hours, but what you're about to discover could save your life.
Hello, Your Excellency. It is an honor.
Come closer now, good people. Don't be afraid. Come, celebrate the miracle of science. You won't believe your eyes.
You'll find all you need in our selection. Whatever you need to be!
Sir Desade, I presume. It is an honor to make your acquaintance. Captain, you set sail soon. Have you seen to our little business?
Yes. We were finally able to recover your merchandise.
Excellent news. I'm afraid, though, that your mission isn't completely finished, Kurt.
Blast me. I'm a captain, not an errand boy.
The commander was quite explicit.
Very well. What do I need to do?
The merchandise that you obtained needs to be sent to Tirfredi as soon as possible. But the Port Authority formalities for shipping take an eternity to wade through. And we've already lost quite a bit of time with this dishonest merchant.
Are you blatantly asking us to smuggle this merchandise in contraband?
I would never ask you to do such a thing, Your Excellency.
Ah, but you don't mind asking that of Kurt?
Well, now, if he finds an alternative solution that is less illegal, that would be fine. The method matters not. But this cargo must reach the Isle on the next ship.
Marvelous.
Well then, I await your return with utmost impatience. I'm certain you shall do what's required.
Idea who I am. Open up, imbeciles! I have a ship to catch!
Do you hear that?
Yes, that's Constantine's voice. It's coming from the upper floor. It sounds as if he's locked up.
And I have a feeling they're expecting company. Be careful. The slightest itchy word to these brutes will have them drawing blades to scratch it.
Negotiation may be the solution. As you say, this breed of brutes won't spit on ransom money.
What a waste. I'd rather sneak around them than give half a coin to these seedy fellows.
It's not possible just now. It's blocked.
guard out if you keep shouting like that. We should have gotten rid of him.
Don't be an idiot. It's obvious that he's a noble, a rich man. He needed to be taught a lesson, but it's better we grab some coin. With all those posters we posted, someone with...
To my help! And death to the others!
Move away! Things are about to get dicey!
Locked. Locked.
Well, this has been monumentous, gentlemen, but I have more important things to attend to. An island to govern, treaties to sign, riches to expedite, and a demanding father to impress!
Constantine, it's me!
My dear cousin! Oh, my lucky star! Always there to pull me out of my fires.
I do what I can. We're departing soon. Your father wasn't pleased by your absence this morning.
Have you ever seen him happy about anything when it comes to me? You know what he thinks of me.
He cares about you. I know that. He appointed you governor, didn't he?
He is ridding himself of a source of constant disappointment. Enough said. Today we set sail for adventure.